I have the honor to share a brief history of a great man, my grandfather, Ronald Gary Sweet. I am going to refer to him simply as Grandpa. I am Jason Perkins, his oldest grandson. Grandpa was born on November 21st, 1938. His parents were Robert and Mary. He had one brother, Robert Jr., and one sister, Suzanne. He served in the Navy valiantly for 3 years. After the Navy, he learned the trade of a tool and die maker, or as he called it, I make parts that make parts for parts. He learned this trade in his dad's tool and die shop and continued to work in this trade until the day he retired. In Grandpa's downtime, he loved playing golf and especially loved teaching and playing this game with his family. Grandpa loved watching movies, and we would often stay up late when I visited his house watching movies. Grandpa also loved music, every type of music. I remember driving on road trips with Grandpa. And getting in the car to a surprise of rap music playing. Something that I didn't experience as much as others was I heard Grandpa was a great dancer. Grandpa also loved having family over. And when I say family, I mean everyone. He loved everyone and knew no stranger. Grandpa lived to be 81. As he passed away due to complications of Alzheimer's, and even through the many years of this disease, his love for music never stopped. If you sung a song to him during that time, he would start to dance in his seat, and a big smile would come to his face. The life he lived is worthy of a poem I want to share called The Dash. I read of a man who stood to speak at the funeral of a friend. He referred to the dates on the tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that first came the date of birth and spoke of the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the dash between those years. For that dash represents all the time they spent alive on earth. And now only those who love them know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. So think about this long and hard. Are there things you'd like to change? For you never know how much time is left that can still be rearranged. To be less quick to anger and show appreciation, more love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say about how you lived your dash? The dash are the memories we will hear from those he leaves behind, also known as his legacy. I know my grandpa left a great legacy. His wife, Brenda Sweet, his daughter, Christina Sample, and her husband, Tommy, his son, Ronald Yankee Gary Sweet, his other son, Ryan Sweet, and his wife, Christina. His daughter, Teresa Cancel, and her husband, Henry. His daughter, Tina Burns, and her husband, John. His 16 grandchildren, 24 great-grandchildren. Now I have the opportunity of sharing one of my fondest memories of Grandpa, which is spending a week every summer with Grandma and Grandpa. When we went to Grandpa's house, we had so much fun. We stayed up late watching movies, had a pizza night. He loved some good pizza. We would get up in the morning, go to get McDonald's for breakfast. But Grandpa would always, at least one morning while we were there, make his famous monkey bread, a tradition spread throughout the family. The most fun I had with Grandpa, though, was always in the car. Most older people I knew drove slow, didn't really listen to music while driving. Not Grandpa. I never remember going slow or in a silent vehicle when riding with Grandpa. Grandpa would drive fast and always had music playing. He seemed to love driving, and it showed. This is something that I know both me and my sister still today enjoy when driving. Grandpa will always be missed, and I look forward to hearing everyone's memories. On behalf of our family, I want to thank everyone for their love and support they have shown, especially during such a difficult time, when it's so difficult to be there. I also want to thank everyone that has shared the memories so Grandpa could be remembered forever through the memories of each of you. Thank you. Grandpa, may you live on forever. And I look forward to joining you again for a ride on Heaven's Highway. I love you.
I was walking home from school on a cold winter day. Took a shortcut through the woods, and I lost my way. It was getting late, and I was scared and alone. But then a kind old man took my hand and led me home. Now mama couldn't see him, oh, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart he was the answer to my prayers. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. When life held troubled times and had me down on my knees, there's always been someone to come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger, to lend a helping hand. A phone call from a friend, just to say I understand. But ain't it kind of funny, at the dark end of the road, that someone lights the way with just a single ray of hope. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. They wear so many faces, show up in the strangest places, to grace us with their mercy in our time of need. From somewhere up above, they come to you and me in our darkest hours, to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love, to guide us with the light of love.
After working as a banquet waitress, a friend and I stopped by a lounge to relax after work. While we were there, a good-looking guy came over and asked me to dance. Ron and I danced as if we were always together. We fit together and everything was perfect. I think I fell in love with him during our first dance. By the way, I gave him my phone number. On our first date, we went to the movies. We saw Bedknob and Broomsticks. We had our children with us, Chris, Ryan, Yank, Tina, and Teresa. I thought all was great. Our lives were truly meant to be. We were married May the 30th, 1972, not too long after we'd met. Our lives included the kids and trips we took. It was great fun. He always supported me by being a part of the church activities, softball tournaments, and daddy-daughter dinners, and dance. Ron always treated me as if I was a queen and loved me always as I loved him. Time seemed to fly by so quickly. All three of our girls were married so close together. We went from five kids to just the two of us. We loved each other even more. He surprised me by joining the church. And we were sealed together for all time and eternity in Orlando in 2001. How thankful I am for my sweet one and all the years we were together on this earth. I know he will comfort me when my turn comes. We can be together forever with our families. Just think, all this happened with just a dance. I know he is having a wonderful time with the family in heaven and probably playing golf too. I hope I'll be a better golfer in heaven than I am here on earth. I miss him every single day. I want to thank so many wonderful people in my life. Alan and Kim being my support team from the very beginning, with Tina and John coming to live with me that I would be safe. Teresa, for taking me into her home to be my support team in Arizona. Robbie, for doing all this video. And I'm also grateful for my sister Gail, Rob's mother, and they did all their help by phone. All this, and all those who sent me cards and phone calls, I deserve a great big thank you. I appreciate all. I especially am grateful for all the prayers that everyone has given me, especially my church family. I love you all, and thanks for putting up with me.
I decided to put my tribute to my brother in the form of a letter. And after many failed attempts, I've come up with this. So here we go. Dear Ronnie, so hard to believe my big brother is no longer with us, but hope you are hearing us today because we have all come together to say goodbye to a very sweet and loving, always kind and gentle man. My brother, husband, father, stepfather, grandfather, uncle, and great-grandfather, and on it goes. I've been thinking back to the early years, because I guess that's what a sister would do, when we were growing up in Kent on Wilkett Avenue. It was a dead-end street, but there were 28 kids that lived on that street, which was great for us. I remember every summer we would play kick the can practically every night, but of course we had to go home when the streetlights came on. That was the rule. But what great memories those were. It was fun. There was Mom and Dad, you and me, and little brother Robbie. We had a great childhood with the greatest parents ever. When you boys got older and started playing golf, which was the premier sport of the family, as everyone knows, You and Bob would hitchhike out to Twin Lakes Country Club to caddy practically every day, all summer long. You guys loved your golf, and you were very good at it, I might add. After graduating Roosevelt High School, you enlisted in the Navy, and off you went to explore the world. I remember when I heard they shipped you off to Korea, I was so scared for you. I really didn't want you to go. But you came back all healthy and well, but we missed you so much. I remember a couple years after that, when you were stationed out in San Diego, a friend of mine and I flew out to San Diego to visit you for a week. And you showed us around everywhere. You took us to the greatest places, beautiful things I had never seen before. And we just had the best time. I will always remember that trip out there with you. It was great. Now we'll fast forward to 1970 and our lives in Florida. That was the best. Mom and Dad were already living down there. So it was a chance for us to enjoy Florida living as well. So we picked up and moved, you and Kathy and the three kids, and Bob and I. Our children weren't born yet. They were born in Florida. So there we were in Florida, and it was great because we were all together, somewhat anyway, kept our family together. We enjoyed and celebrated birthdays, holidays, anniversaries, graduations, all together as the years waned on. Also, many family golf tournaments. That was always happening. We did have a great time. I know the last 10 years have been torture for you, fighting Alzheimer's. So similar to how Dad suffered. You probably don't know this, but your wonderful, strong, saintly wife has been by your side every step of the way. But maybe you do know that, but we don't know. Brenda, I can't say enough about the loving care you have given Ronnie over the years. You're the best. Hopefully you have joined Mom, Dad, and Bob, and you are all at peace now. I will forever hold you in my heart. I love you. Bye-bye.
Hello, my name is Mary Dutterer. My mom is Susie Nolte, and she's Ronnie's sister, so Ronnie was always Uncle Ronnie to me. And I loved Ronnie very much. I always saw him as being someone just super sweet and nice. But recently I've been going through a lot of stuff in my room and kind of throwing things out. And I came across, I actually ended up having a lot of photos from way back. So I thought I'd share a couple with you of Ronnie when he was very young. Now, the quality on these is going to be a little different because it's hard for me to take off some of the coverings on these paper or these pictures because some of them will tear. This is some really old stuff, but what we have here is Ronnie's baby picture, and here's where he's a little bit older. Look at that face. And next one, here he is. He's a little bit older, but I'm sure all of you that knew Ronnie definitely can remember that grin of his. He always had such a wonderful sense of humor. I love the little outfit he has on here. And here he is, a little bit older. And here's a picture of him and my mom when my mom was a little baby. He wasn't all that much older. And here is a picture of Ronnie and Mom and Grandma Sweet. And this is one that I really love. It's a picture of Ronnie and Mom together. I don't really know what ages they were, but they look pretty young then. And then here we have a picture of Ronnie and my mom and Bob Jr. And here's another one of the three of them together, Ronnie and Mom and Bob Jr. And I wanted to get to this one. This looks like, I don't know if this was his junior or senior prom, but here's him dressed up to go to the prom. Here's one I wanted to share. Look at this guy. Ronnie in the Navy. Aren't those great? So I hope you enjoyed those pictures of Ronnie when he was little. I sure think they're pretty special. I will always have really great memories of Ronnie. I know most people do. He was just an incredibly sweet, nice, kind man. And we'll miss him very, very much. Thank you.
Hi, Brenda and the rest of the family. It's so good to be with you, even though it's just video. First of all, let me say how much I wish I could be with you right now, that this whole virus has kept us away from each other, and to be able to be there and give you a hug, I just wish I could do that. This is the best we can do right now. I probably don't have as many memories of Ron as the rest of the family does, because we didn't live down there. The only time that we were around Ron was when we were on vacation, which was always a happy time for us. And Ron always made us feel welcome. No matter how many kids we brought or how many grandkids we brought, we always found a place for them. And I appreciate that he just opened up his home to us, and we were always just like brothers and sisters to him as well as to Brenda. One of the vacations that I really remember is the vacation that we took to Alaska, and how much fun that was, how cold it was. But Ron always had a smile on his face and always glad to be with us and always happy to get to see all the good places and eat all the good food. And we just really had a good time, and I'm so glad that I was able to be with him on one of his last vacations that he was able to take. A couple of the things that I remember about Ron was when we were down there on vacation, how he always made popcorn for everybody in that little bitty pot. And I always wondered why he didn't use a bigger pot, but he always managed, and that was his pot to make the popcorn in. And his monkey bread was the first experience that I had with monkey bread, and it's become a tradition with our family. We always have that for Christmas, and any time that we're all together, we always have monkey bread for breakfast, and so I'm glad that he was able to share that with me. One of the special things that he did in his life was to join our church, and Brenda wanted that for a long time, because the church means a lot to us, and it's something that you can do together as a family and have the same beliefs. And when Ron did that, that made Brenda really happy and made all of us really happy. And then when he was able to go to the temple with her and be sealed together for all time and eternity, that's a very special thing. And I know that it gives Brenda a lot of comfort right now, that she knows that she'll be with him again once she passes on, and that he'll be there to welcome her home. The last time we visited was in February, and I came down with Rob, and we went over to the nursing home to visit with Ron, and he always acted like he knew me. I don't know whether he really did or not, but he always acted like he knew me, and I was glad Rob was there, because Rob was able to help and make him laugh, and that was like Ron. That was him if he's laughing, I was just really glad I was able to see him in February, and then just the COVID was just right around the corner, and so we weren't able to come down and see him again, and I think the nursing home closed down right after that, so I'm really glad I was able to see him. And I'm sure there's other memories I've got of Ron, but right off the top of my head, I can't think of them, and I just wish I was there to be with you. Sure gonna miss you, Brenda, whenever she moves to Arizona. Maybe we can make it out there sometime to see her, or she can make it back this way to see us. And we love all of you and wish we could see all of you and be all together. And I'll sign off now. Love you. Bye-bye.
I just wanted to talk about my dad. He was my dad since I was 9 years old. He's the one who pretty much raised me. I'm grateful for everything that he has done for me, his support. Whether I made wrong or right choices, he was always there for me. And he was a lot of fun. We would have popcorn movie nights where he would shake his butt and make his popcorn. And I remember playing Yahtzee after we went swimming in the pool almost every night, especially during the summer. It was so much fun. And he had this afro when afros were popular. He got his hair permed, and we had a van that was covered with carpet from head to toe. We all the kids went in there with us to different places. We went to have pizza in different places. It was a lot of fun. And that's another thing we did. We would go find these little pizza joints and go to them. They were like mom and pop pizza joints, and they were really good. He loved to go to art shows, and we always went to art shows and walked around and saw all the different art. He really appreciated artwork. I really enjoyed, too, watching Little House on the Prairie with him. And if there was a sad part and you looked over at him, you'd see just tears falling down his face. He was very sensitive, even though you wouldn't know it until you watched Little House on the Prairie. But that was one of the sensitive things that I remember about him. He was a good dad, and I am so glad and grateful that he was in my life, and I will miss him. And I love him. Love you, Dad. Bye.
Hey, I just wanted to share a few memories that I have of my dad when I was little. One of my favorite memories was the Stryker-Likers soccer team. He used to take us to the games, me to the games. He also took Daryl when he came down. We would go to the games. We'd go see the cheerleaders and the after parties. He also used to take me up to the draft house for lunch. We also had a father-daughter dance at the church. And he didn't just take me. He took my best friend, Rhonda, bought us both wrist corsages, and made sure he danced with both of us. And it was very, very special, and I miss him a whole lot. Mom, I wanted to tell you that I love you with all my heart, and it has been an honor for me to take care of you and be with you in the time that we've had together. I love you. Bye.
Well, we all miss Ron a lot, and I have a lot of good memories of Ron. I've never seen him angry. I've never heard him talk bad about people. I've never heard him cuss or have any kind of problems or issues at all. And I remember when me and Kim moved up here, he had to do the picking up and delivery. And the thing of it was, he knew Lakeland like the back of his hand, and we'd always go one way and come back a different way, and it took me forever to learn how to get around here. But he was probably the kindest person I've ever met, as far as never saying anything bad or being angry. He was always calm. And we're going to miss you greatly, Ron, and rest in peace. Whenever you go to Arizona, we're going to miss you a lot. And I know that we've been together for a long time as far as our shop is concerned. And it's really going to hit hard when you're really, truly gone for a while. So you have a good time in Arizona with your daughter and grandkids and stuff, and we'll be in touch.
I can always remember Uncle Ron living up to his last name as Sweet. When I first moved to Lakeland, he was someone that I always hung out with because I didn't know how to drive, and he always took me where I needed to go. I was in school, and he would take me back and forth to school. I worked with Aunt Brenda and Dad at the shop, and Uncle Ron and I were co-workers. We delivered furniture together. We stripped furniture together. We just always hung out, and he was always just so kind and so nice, and never told me no, that he wouldn't take me somewhere, although I never really asked him to take me very many places because his driving scared the bejesus out of me. I was appreciative of him, and I was appreciative of everything that he did for me, and I'll always remember him and be thankful that I had him in my life and was able to get to know him. Aunt B, I love you, and I will miss you terribly when you go to Arizona. But I wish you the very best, and I wish you nothing but happiness and joy, and you will be in my prayers always. I love you so much, and wishing everybody the best.
Hi, I'm Rob Caldwell. I'm Ron's nephew. It's been my pleasure to edit together this video of everyone's memories of Ron. As I've been going through all of the family videos, you can always hear Ron. You can always hear him laughing in the background, or you can see him like lifting up a baby or smiling, laughing about something that one of the kids is doing. You can always hear him. He was always a part of our family. He was always there. And I'm really glad that I had an opportunity not that long ago to go down to Florida and visit with Ron. And although he had Alzheimer's, and I am pretty sure he didn't know who I was, he always smiled. He always looked over at me and smiled as if to let me know that he knew who I was. At least that's how it felt. I always remember Ron being super patient and kind, very kind. Never saw him get angry. And even when he had Alzheimer's at the nursing home, there would be times where something would kind of irritate him, like maybe he was being moved and something would pinch him, and you could tell he was in pain or he would be really irritated. At least when I was there, he always went out of his way to apologize and smile afterwards and let us know that he cared about us. When I was down in Florida last time visiting with Aunt Brenda, she kind of pulled me aside and she asked me if I would put together a slideshow for her and Ron when they die. And, that wasn't the kind of thing I'd normally want to be talking about on vacation. And she felt bad for even asking me, but she wanted me to know that she's not afraid of death and that it's just a normal part of God's plan for us. And, you know, her testimony of the fact that we'll all be together again someday really strengthens me. And Aunt Brenda, I just want you to know how much I love you and will miss you when you're in Arizona. We'll have to come visit sometime, maybe in the winter. But thank you for who you are and for your faith. Your faith in the gospel has helped strengthen me, and it helps me to know that we'll all be together again someday.
Hi, I wanted to start off by just telling a couple memories of Grandpa when I was a kid. Something that I always wanted to learn how to do was play golf. And I always messed around, you know, when we were on the military post and things like that. But once we were in Florida, Grandpa taught me how to play golf, at least mostly his version of it, which one of the things that I remember the most is improving your lie. So that meant propping the ball up a little bit better, or maybe using your foot to tap it in a better direction. But that was what I remember of playing golf with him the most, was always getting a better position to get it closer to the hole. So it was always fun being on the golf course with him, and we always had a good time. We were able to talk about a lot of stuff, and it was always something that I looked forward to doing with him, even if it was just going to the driving range or something like that. And as I got older, we didn't get to do it as much, but every now and then got to go with him. And, you know, even when he retired and he's working at Sandpiper cleaning golf carts, you know, we would go and mess around, and he would show me where he worked and all that type of stuff. So he was always very passionate about what he did, no matter what it was. So when we were alone, he talked to me about, you know, working at the machine shop and all that type of stuff. So it was always fun being with him one-on-one. And one of the things that I really remembered is anytime we had a conversation, he always brought everything back to Grandma. So when I got older and I had conversations with him, he always put it in perspective of his life with Grandma, how much it meant to him to have a partner in Grandma. And a lot of that, excuse me, a lot of that helped me be who I am today. I've never told anyone that. I don't think I've even told you, Grandma, but he did help me in a lot of situations that most of you don't know about. But my kids hate being on camera, hate having their pictures taken. So they wanted me to tell you, Grandma, that they really love you and they miss you. And I really love and miss you. And no matter if you're here or if you're out in Arizona, I'm always a phone call away. And if I need to come out there and see you, I'll come out there and see you, whatever I need to do. But ultimately, you and Grandpa have made a huge impression on my life. And I'm going to terribly miss Grandpa. So I know it's only like 3.5 minutes, but that's all I got. So thank you.
Hi, Grandma. I just wanted to say and share a few memories of Grandpa. One being when I was little and I used to mix up my ice cream. He'd always look at me and say, if you're going to do that, you might as well drink it through a straw. Or him making monkey bread. Or him teaching me how to bake, because he was such a good baker. Or when he was diagnosed with Alzheimer's and he didn't remember that I was pregnant and I was really, really close to delivering. And he looked at me so confused and he goes, Kim, what happened? You got so big. It was so funny. And then when I explained that I was pregnant and having my first baby, he was so excited. Every time I told him, he was just so excited. I really do miss him a lot. And I'm gonna miss you too when you go to Arizona. And I love you very, very, very much.
Hey, Grandma, just want to tell you I love you, and I don't know really how to express the loss of Grandpa, but I mean, I wish he was still here. I wish I had spent more time with him, but I love you, and I wish you well on all your travels.
I have a lot of great memories of Grandpa. Most of them come from the weeks Jason and I would spend at their house during the summer. I remember Grandpa making popcorn almost every night. I remember making monkey bread with him for holidays and looking for golf balls all over the golf course. But I also love my memories of visiting him in the nursing home and bringing my kids there and them singing songs to him and helping Grandma pass out the snacks for bingo. And I'm going to miss getting to visit him when I come to Florida, but I know that he's with us, and we're going to miss him lots, and I hate that my kids won't get to know him the way that I did, because he was a good man, and we were lucky to have him in our lives, and he'll be missed for sure, and I love you so much, Grandma.
Love you!